Welcome back, Heat Seekers, to the week 4 quarterback tier rankings you need to know to help get your lineups ready so you can win this week.
Everything's on fire. Everything's on fire. Everything's on fire.
Thank you guys, as always, for hanging out with us, checking out our videos, leaving comments and likes and all that stuff. We appreciate it. It helps the channel grow. It helps YouTube know that you guys enjoy what we're doing here. Don't forget to hit that like, the subscribe, the notification icon, share it with a friend, share it with your grandparents. Whoever plays fantasy football, this can help them. That being said, let's get to it. QB1 overall this week. So we think that there are 6 guys that could be QB1 overall. Kyler, Josh, Patrick, Lamar, Dak, and Stafford. Kraig, what do you think about these guys, and is there somebody that you are concerned with in their matchups this week?
Well, I mean, you can always come up with potential concern if you really want to for pretty much anybody here. Looking at the top of the list here, you know, 2 of these face each other with Kyler and Stafford going against each other's teams. Even with the issues that that Tampa had this past week for him, you know, It wasn't one of those things where Brady fell off a cliff. I think he, you know, was still a top 5 in most formats quarterback for the past week. So, yeah, Murray is fine. Allen showed that, you know, we're not going to be having to concern ourselves with him, you know, against a defense that was supposed to be a lot better than it showed in Washington. And he faces Houston this week. No concerns there. Mahomes against Philadelphia. We saw what Dallas did. Lamar Jackson against Denver. The Denver defense has been really improved. And if you want to talk about which one of these, it's probably either him or Dak at the top of the list here that I'd have the most concern about maybe falling farthest from what we think they could reach here. But they're by no means, you know, world beaters that they're going against. And Lamar, especially his rushing ability, is always going to give him that high upside. So Dak or Lamar, maybe. As far as I'd have it towards the bottom, but no concerns really overall.
Yeah, I'm with you. Because I see it as a bit of a revenge game, I wanted to put Brady in the QB1 overall. Like, I feel like he'd go up there and face that team from Foxborough that he does not care for anymore because he's now in Tampa and just destroy them. You know, I don't know that it's going to happen, but it just feels like, you know, that would be a Brady thing to do. Just come back and show them what they gave up on. But yeah, this list is strong. We know the offense in LA goes through Stafford in that passing game, and all these guys, I mean, have really great upside. Lamar is the one that scares me the most of the QB1 overall. But I mean, again, these are all must start guys. You don't have them on your teams to not start them. So absolutely agree. QB1 though, there are some interesting names in here that I don't know that in previous weeks we would have had in this list. So we've got A-Rod. No surprise. Russell Wilson, Tom Brady, Joe Burrow, Baker, Derek Carr, Justin Herbert, Jalen Hurts, Ryan Tannehill, Sam Darnold, Kirk Cousins. So of the QB1s, you know, at this point now we've now talked about, you know, 16-ish names of players. Which one of these guys could you see not really being a QB1 and being more a QB2 because he has a rough matchup or a bad game?
Out of the list in here, you know, my initial thought was Tannehill, but they're going against the Jets. So I really don't think we're going to run into that, no matter who they have sort of as a receiving core. If it does happen, I think it's more a result of them deciding to run the ball more. The other one, just based off of what we've seen in 2 out of the 3 weeks, the rushing upside saves him. But, you know, Jalen Hurts, he was a QB2 against Dallas, the game that we just saw on Monday night. And then in week 2, I think he was right around that borderline of QB1, QB2. So going against a Kansas City team that's going to be, I think they play Kansas City, right? Yeah.
I think so, yeah.
That's going to be upset after that last game. That's a better defense than what Dallas has. I'm going to go out on a limb and say that overall right now. So I could see Hurts falling out. And then if Dallas is for real, and as a Dallas fan, I can tell you too often they have a great game like they did Monday night, and then they don't the next week. But, you know, Sam Darnold doesn't have, like, the world's best offensive weapons around him, where I could see him just not putting up numbers that we had the first couple weeks and falling more to QB2.
Yeah, he's the one that I'm very concerned about. Facing Dallas, who I like where their defense is going. It's not there yet, but it's getting better. And that offensive line in Carolina is terrible. Like, they traded for a cornerback. They really need to trade for five new offensive linemen. I mean, there's just not a lot to like about that. And that hurts for Darnold because he's not getting a lot of time to throw. And Darnold can move around and has a little bit of wiggle room in his game, but he's not, you know, Jalen Hurts or Russell Wilson. I mean,
yeah,
he may extend a couple of plays with his feet, but he's not extending every play with his feet. So that's the one I'm concerned most about. Him and Jalen Hurts have the biggest concerns in my mind. I mean, Hurts' rushing upside helped, but it definitely, his lack of proper passing upside really hurts him. You know, and I've already started to hear little rumblings from people talking about, when's Minshew going to get a turn? Because Hurts is just not really doing anything for them right now. And that's from an NFL perspective, obviously. From a fantasy perspective, back in QB1, up end, or, you know, high end QB2, which is kind of where we had pegged him early on before the season started. Yep. So, yeah. Now, onto the QB2s, this is a bunch of guys that are been a roller coaster so far. You know, Teddy Bridgewater, Jameis Winston had a huge week one, has been down since. Daniel Jones has probably been the most consistently strong of this group, and he's putting up solid fantasy production this year, even though they're not winning. Taylor Heinicke's got some rushing upside. You know, Matt Ryan had a solid game and a win. Jared Goff had a great week one, kind of keep going downhill, and then Jimmy Garoppolo's been meh. So of these QB2s, like, what are you making of this group? Is there anybody you're excited about or feel comfortable starting if need be? Who are you looking at?
I certainly like Teddy Bridgewater. He's throwing downfield a lot more than people thought. Even just, you know, for NFL this year, you know, throws of 20 yards or more, he's up near the top. Mm. So that offense, you know, even with its injuries, has been better than expected. And the Giants, I don't think, are going to, you know, blow them out of the water and force them out of their game plan. Taylor Heinicke has been sneaky good, and he's going against Atlanta, whose defense has not been good. So he's certainly someone with upside. And the rest of them, I mean, Matt Ryan maybe, because that Washington defense just hasn't shown a lot. But I tell you, if there's a week that I think their defensive line starts to get things right against that Atlanta offensive line, you know, Matt Ryan could be in for a long day, so this is probably the right zone for him. Mm-hmm. And Goff has looked better than a lot of people thought, too, but the Bears' defense is still trying, at least, even if their offense isn't getting going. So, you know, they're going to stick to running more. And Winston, I think it's been good week, bad week, good week. So I think we're in line for a bad week for Winston based on his performance this season. So maybe don't be counting on him too much, even though he's going against the Giants, and their defense just lost their top linebacker, Blake Martinez, for the year. They still have a good defensive line, and they still have a really good secondary. So I'm not expecting a quote-unquote good week for Jameis this week.
Yeah, I would absolutely agree. If I'm putting these guys in order, it's probably, you know, Teddy, Daniel, Heinicke, Goff, Ryan, Jameis, Garoppolo, you know, and personally speaking, at least. I mean, it's a tough group because any of them have the potential to have a pretty big boom week, but matchups, inefficiency at times. I mean, there's enough concern where you're like, okay, let's just pump the brakes on some of these guys. Speaking of pumping the brakes, flex and sleepers. This is a group, two groups of what is going on. You know, obviously the biggest concern in all of this is Big Ben has looked terrible. I mean, I've watched clips of him tripping over air. I've watched clips of him throwing wobbly duck pat, like, this is not going well for Pittsburgh offense, and they have a ton of studly fantasy options that Ben is ruining this year. So this is why we've got some of these guys in the flex tier and the sleeper tier, you know, but there's some upside here. Like, of these tiers, you know, talk through where your head's at with these guys. Are any of them comfortable to start? You know, Jacoby Brissett going against his former team, or Mac Jones going against the GOAT? I mean, who in here do you really think might actually give you some value?
Mac Jones, I don't want anything to do with, quite honestly. I know it's the big game with, you know, he's sort of now the heir apparent to Brady, and he's with the old team, but they're not going to have success running the ball, and that offense, as far as pass catching, has not been impressive. Trevor Lawrence, he's got a lot of weapons, but he's going against an upstart Bengals team, and better Bengals defense than I think people expected. And Roethlisberger, I said to start the year, and I've continued to say it, I think he's washed up. I just think he's done. You know, he's a big guy that can't move around very well. Whatever they said he had to do to his arm to make it better, I think it was like his elbow, it doesn't appear to have worked. The one that excites me the most out of the flex group is probably Carson Wentz. You know, we saw the Raiders last week put up some points against Miami and have some success throwing the ball. He has weapons there. He's got tight end. They're still going to run the ball. But out of that group, he's the one that excites me the most. And out of the bottom group, looking at this week anyway, it's probably Jacoby Brissett excites me the most.
He looked efficient. You know, he played well.
Zach Wilson, maybe just because that Tennessee secondary is so bad, but they still have a decent group of pass rushers and defensive line where he's not going to just have a ton of time to throw and take advantage of it. So for me at the bottom is probably Brissett and then Wilson and Fields or Dalton, whoever Nagy decides to pull out of a hat and say is starting and have a terrible game plan for this week.
I mean, they've got to get right game here against Detroit. I mean, that's the only upside is if they start Fields, he should get some rushing upside potentially. Maybe.
Or it's a rock bottom game.
I mean, that's the tough thing is you can't trust it. And, you know, and I want to go back a little to Big Ben. When do we start thinking about them replacing him? Is there a point where, you know, the Steelers are like, listen, we want playoffs and Ben's not getting us there. Do you think they bring in Mason Rudolph or Dwayne Haskins? Should we be telling fantasy owners to start maybe considering targeting these guys to stash them to see if they need quarterback help?
In a lot of deep super flex leagues, which these are mainly for, because, you know, most one quarterback leagues, you're not going this deep unless it's, you know, a 20 or 32 man league or something. But I see Haskins rostered a lot and I don't see Rudolph. And I think that's the right move. Yep. Rudolph may play over Haskins initially, but I think they know what they have in Rudolph and that's not the answer. And Haskins looked good in preseason. There's a reason he was drafted as high as he was. Now, should he have been drafted that high? You know, arguable, but he's got all the talent that you would want in a starting NFL quarterback. See what you have. You know, he does have sort of that bit similar Big Ben type mobility where, you know, he's not quick and fast and nimble, but he can get around and he's a strong guy that can still make plays when he's that guy's coming after him. So that's the one that I would be looking at. Just is that front office, is that ownership going to want to make that move to someone like Ben? It almost feels like when they had Ben come back this year that they were saying, all right, it's up to you what you want to do. You hang it up when you want to, which it's a year too late at this point is what it feels like to me.
Feels very bad. So to wrap this up, we haven't talked about Houston. You know, obviously Davis Mills is still the guy. There really isn't, we didn't even consider him a sleeper this week. You know, is there any situation where you would think starting him makes any sense?
Yeah, if you're in one of those enormous leagues where, you know, every team has like one quarterback, if you're in any even 16-man league, if you're in a 16-man league where you have to start two quarterbacks, not even Superflex, because Superflex, I'd find someone else to put into that Superflex position, quite honestly. But if you have to start two quarterbacks in 16-man league, then yes, of course, you're starting him. But outside of that, no. I mean, Buffalo has, once again, a very good defense, full of playmakers. And Mills has looked better than people thought, but he just does not have what he needs to get protection, to make plays, and do what you would need in a fantasy starter. So I think as a stash long-term, yeah, maybe he could be something, you know, an average starting quarterback in the NFL. But this game against Buffalo, I'm looking elsewhere.
It's definitely going to be a welcome to the NFL type moment for the young man. All right, so that is it, folks. Your week four tiers are in the books. Make sure to check out the running backs, wide receivers, tight ends. Those videos have all dropped or will be dropping here on YouTube. If you have questions, comment below. If you want some last-minute start-sit advice, join us on Sunday morning with Rick and Bryce for the Boomer Bus Show. You guys have been doing a great job making the channel what it is, and we couldn't appreciate you guys more. We thank you for everything you're doing, and we'll see you later.